Frank, and I will give you a brief introduction to the Scuttlebutt stream and why I'm doing it. Yeah, Lars asked me if I can do it, so I'm standing here right now and helping you put it up. This will be brief, just 10 minutes. Okay, so what is it? Scuttlebutt stream is a library for stream processing in Kubernetes.io. It's resource safe. Means you don't actually have to close the resources yourself. So if you use it for file processing, you don't have to close the file yourself. The library will move it for you. It's composable, and the sense that you can have different stream transformation and compose them easily together. And it's functional, meaning that the stream transformations are pure values. Motivation. Let's have a look at the normal style of imperative I/O, or the conventional style, how that looks like in Scala, and we will see later how this can be written with Scala's extreme. So we have here a method, lines greater than 40,000, which checks if a file has more than 40,000 lines. So what this does is open the file. It has counter when it gets the iterator from the open file, which iterates over all lines in this file, and then we have a loop where we implement the counter if there are still lines in this file. And finally, we check if our count is greater than 40,000, and then we finally sort of close our results. So that's not bad. There are things that are good about the solution. One of them is incremental, so the whole file is not loaded into memory upfront, but the method processes the file line by line. And since we are not buffering any lines, there's not like memory usage. But also have the shortcomings. One is that you have to close the file yourself. So if you forget this, you have the resource leak. And then the other bad thing is you have this while loop. And in this while loop, there are two concerns based. And one is that you're going over the lines of the file, and the other is that you count the lines. So that two different concerns, and these are not separated but mixed. And the bad thing about this, you can't compose this. You can't take this out and append it to another operation which also works on the lines of the file. Okay, so how could this message translated to Scuttlebutt stream. This is one possible solution. And you see we have here this lines error file name method, which basically goes over all lines of the file. But we don't actually need to close it ourselves, so the library takes here. And we have a long loop, just methods that are concatenated. And how this works is so we have the stream of lines, and then we say, okay, drop the first 40,000, and then if there's any line after that, we just take that and put it into an option, and then check if this option is correct. And if the file is shorter than 40,000 lines, we get a none. If it's larger, we get a sum of 40,000 and 1. Now to the basic type of Scuttlebutt stream, or the basic idea of Scuttlebutt stream is the process I/O type. The process I/O type is kind of a function that takes a stream of I/O use to a stream of O/O use, but it's not itself a function, but it do this transformation itself, just a description how this transformation should be done. And it's actually a state machine which can be in these three different states. And these states have to be interpreted by a driver for effects to occur. And the state is, first one is the mid, which signals to the driver. We have here these sequence of overlays which should be emitted. And this is head, and then we have the tail, which should be the next state after emitting these values. Then there's the wait phase, which signals to the driver we would like to read an I value and generate a new state from this I value with a receive function. And if there's no more I value available, finalizer will be the state, the next state of this process. And then there's the hold state, which signals to the driver, okay, we don't have, or don't read an I, or don't output an overview from this process. Okay, that's the basic data structure of this dataset stream. I say simplified form, it's actually a little bit more complicated, but to understand the basics, it's done. The nice thing about this process is that you then can find some combinators or other methods on this type that changes how this stream transformation is done. So you can, for example, map over the output values, flatten over them, or append two processes together so that one process runs until it talks and then the next process runs until it talks. So these functions are kind of similar to those functions you find on Scala collections. So for example, this also is map, flat map, and filter take while, or take drop while, and so on. So you can view a process a little bit like a sequence of operations. And there's also this interesting method pipe, which takes for which call on one process and give it another process. It will take the output of the first process and use that as the input for the next process. So you can, this is pipe, use two processes together. Okay. Here's another example that shows how that also reads lines from a file, from the test data file GST, and then removes all lines that are empty or subcomment, and then maps to all lines use. Or the many lines that are not in the comments. This Fahrenheit Celsius function and all values after that. Three all values after that, there's the new line mixed in, and then we use this pipe operator to this pipe method. Modify the strings we have so far into allocated bytes, and these are then written to the desktop that says this GST file, and run this process and then have all our sizes this file. Really, the nice thing is that this is all incremental, and these are only method calls. Okay, that's it. You can find more about Scala's Xtreme Salzburg Android app, it's got a very similar stream. There's a much better introduction to this library. In chapter 15 of the function programming in Scala book, which I highly recommend, very interesting book. And there's also this talk, which was this year on the Scala meeting, Advanced Stream Processing in Scala, which is by one of the authors of the book, which is also a good introduction to this library.